Hi, I'm Dr. Mak. I am a reproductive endocrinologist and infertility specialist at UT Health Austin. I'm here today to talk about what we do know at this point in time about the COVID-19 vaccine and to also address some of the misinformation on the topic. So there have been several studies that have looked at whether the COVID vaccine causes infertility, and there is no evidence at this point that it causes either female or male infertility. A couple of studies from Israel have shown that one really nice study where they did a cycle, IVF cycle before the COVID vaccine, and then couples had another IVF cycle after the COVID vaccine, and they found no difference in egg count or any difference in the pregnancy rate. So that's reassuring data that there is no difference for those who are going through fertility treatments. The CDC have been tracking and sort of the COVID vaccine, and they've had several registries. They just published some data on, I think, over 120,000 women who had registered for the vaccine and sort of looked at sort of different complications. And they found that the miscarriage rate was no higher than the general population that we know of after the COVID vaccine. So there is no evidence that there is increased risk of miscarriage after the COVID vaccine. During the pregnancy, the baby potentially could receive antibodies that have been generated from mom across the placenta. After pregnancy, they have shown that there may be some antibodies passing through the breast milk, so that may be another way that the baby could receive some antibodies. But I think at this point, ideally, once we know that it's safe in younger children, that ideally the COVID vaccine would probably be the better form to have antibodies. The maternal antibodies that are generated should be safe for the baby, because this is sort of a natural immunity that is passed down to the baby. So that's why most likely it is a safe way for the baby to have the antibodies. Pregnant women are not more likely to get COVID, but when they do get COVID, they're more likely to have the serious illness. Well, one, because they're pregnant, and if they're not vaccinated, that's kind of two things that will make it even more of a high risk to get COVID during pregnancy. And the reported serious complications that they're more likely to go to the ICU, they're more likely to need help with breathing. It can also lead to preterm delivery and preeclampsia. And so definitely, you know, there is, especially with the Delta variant, more pregnant women are being admitted and having the more serious, requiring ICU intubation. And there have been some maternal deaths, whereas with the first wave, that was less likely that we would have any maternal deaths, but it's definitely a very serious disease. I strongly recommend to all my patients trying to get pregnant, who are pregnant, to really have the COVID vaccine, because the benefits really outweigh any of the risks, which are minimal as far as we know from the evidence that we have. So I always counsel my patients to have the COVID vaccine. However, it is a personal decision, and each patient will have to decide in their mind the risk versus the benefits.